In the new Jujutsu Kaisen Chapter 234, it is actually revealed that Sukuna has a final trump card that we just don't know about. But what if I told you that actually in this very chapter that came out yesterday, it was already revealed what his trump card is, and people just haven't seen it yet. And this final move of Sukuna's, or his secret move, right, his trump card, this is what's going to defeat Gojo, and the only one who can actually stop this via actual mythology, which Gege based it off on, is Kashimo. And of course, as you've guessed with the title and the thumbnail, it is Mahoraga. Divine Totality. So best believe you're going to want to watch this whole video because we got a lot of crazy theories this video. So hey, do boy slow and leave a like, it does help out. And of course, if you haven't already subscribed for a ton of Jujutsu Kaisen content, spoiler videos, analysis, power scaling, what ifs, and even live streams too. So if you love JJK, you won't regret it. And of course, thank you to the honored one and special member of the channel, it's Kaisen that guy Trey. Thank you guys very much. Alright, so in the previous chapter, we actually saw that there was a totality of Nue and some other Shikigami. And in this chapter, it was revealed just what those Shikigami were that created this totality. So specifically, it was Nue, right? It was the main host, and it was a combination of the round deer, the mourned tiger, which we just don't know. I guess we never saw what it was, but yes, it's confirmed that this was the final Shikigami. It was a really cool tiger. It would have been really cool to actually see what it was. And of course, the great serpent, which we saw Sukuna actually destroy in the first couple chapters of JJK when he was fighting three-fingered Sukuna. And now we saw in the recent chapter that Nue itself is now destroyed. And it's really interesting because it seems the mourned tiger is something that was destroyed off-screen. Now, maybe this is a Shikigami that was destroyed when before the series started, so Megumi tamed it and it just happened to be super weak and it was destroyed earlier on. Or it could be a new Shikigami that only Sukuna got, but just like he apparently did with the round deer, he apparently destroyed it off screen to add it to totality. So maybe in the same way he tamed the tiger and then destroyed that off screen just to add it to totality. Now, at least so far, what this means is that there's 5 confirmed Shikigami which are completely destroyed. So Nue, Great Serpent, Round Deer, Mourn Tiger, and of course one of the divine dogs. And we know possibly at least that the Max Elephant probably isn't destroyed yet, since we saw Sukuna was actually using its abilities, but it's possible that maybe to actually use the ability of the Max Elephant, he perhaps destroyed it before. So at least that one's unclear, though likely Max Elephant is alive. And we also saw that the rabbits were alive, though the rabbits are a very special case because you can't actually destroy them outright, as they will just keep multiplying. They are very special. However, it is possible that as Sukuna has destroyed some Shikigami off-screening, they may have destroyed other ones too. Now, what do you think would happen if all of the Shikigami, so the rest of them, were destroyed? So in some way Gojo destroys the rabbits, or even Sukuna himself could just destroy them for the sake of adding it to totality, and all 9 of them are gone. All the totality has to go to a Shikigami. We know it all falls under one at least, as the power is passed down to the other shadows. It's possible that the only way Mahoraga can get the other Shikigami's power and a condition for that is for the rest of the Shikigami to be destroyed, and that is the final condition for all the Shikigami's power or shadow to actually go to Mahoraga itself. And Mahoraga would be the final totality. Perhaps this is actually Sukuna's endgame and this is what he's gunning for. It would be pretty incredible if that's kind of like the final trump card where, okay, so you defeat the rest of the Shikigami and Mahoraga is still around. But what are you going to do if Mahoraga just becomes insanely powerful and unbeatable? Because even right now, Gojo can destroy Mahoraga as it hasn't adapted to red or purple. But first of all, if it adapts to those, then it really is over for Gojo. And if on top of that, then it just gets the totality or the absorption of the rest of the Shikigami. Because we actually saw with Agito that Agito got the properties of the other Shikigami and their abilities. So for example, Agito got all the healing and reverse curse technique abilities of the round deer. It was able to actually just heal itself with reverse curse technique. So what this means is that, let's say Mahoraga gets that, Mahoraga already has a healing factor, but it would just get a much stronger one, and it would mean that Mahoraga can heal Sukuna too. And then if it gets Nue's lightning, maybe the Max Elephant's water, Nue's wings, or Divine Totality's claws and such. Maybe like the rabbits, it can multiply itself, though that probably is taking it too far, but you get what I mean, right? It can get its abilities, and on top of that, it just in general, it becomes a lot stronger. Since we saw even when the Divine Dog became a totality, the combination of the two were far, far stronger than just both of them regularly. So the bare minimum, Mahoraga would just generally become way stronger on top of all of its abilities that it would get, such as increased healing, it can heal Sukuna, of course, lightning, water, light, claws, and whatever else. Pretty much, it's going to be unstoppable, and I do think that this could be, of course, I can't confirm, but this could be the final move that Sukuna is holding in to defeat Gojo with, right? Because we know that Mahoraga is the only one that can beat Gojo. I mean, we even saw Sukuna is playing support for Mahoraga. He's just helping him out to beat Gojo. He is firing a couple shots here and there, but mainly it's just support. Now, who's going to stop this thing? Of course, it's going to be Kashimo. Now, if you haven't seen my video I made on Kashimo, I will give a very, very brief summary on that, but I would recommend watching that one. Pretty much, there is an actual mythology that Gege has based all this on. And in this mythology, there are characters just like Sukuna, Kashimo, and Mahoraga, and all of them have the exact same abilities. The character that Sukuna is based based off of Arjuna has a weapon just like Sukuna does in his cover page. The character that Kashimo is based off of, Krishna, actually has a one-time lightning-based attack. And the character that Mahoraga is based off of, Gakugacha, is actually an underling of Arjuna, so Sukuna in this case, and he also has an ability to adapt to every ability and any and all phenomena. Wow, that sounds very similar, doesn't it? It sounds like it's exactly what's going on in the story, and it's exactly what's going to happen, because in the story, so Krishna, who Kashimo plays as, uses one-time attack on the person that Mahoraga is based off of, and he wanted to use it on the person Sukuna is based off of, but he just doesn't get the chance, and instead just uses it on Gakugacha. So what this means is that if all the Shikigami are dead, and they all go into Mahoraga, and Mahoraga is super powerful, it's great that Mahoraga is very powerful, but the issue is that if you destroy Mahoraga, well, that's it. You have no more Shikigami, right? The Ten Shadows just ceases to exist. I mean, I guess you would still have the ability of shadow manipulation, so we saw Sukuna could go into the shadows and come out and hide in the shadows and store weapons. So it's not like you have nothing, you at least have that, but I guess that's it. You actually just use the main function of the Ten Shadows, which is kind of incredible if all the Shikigami die. I mean, what would happen in that situation? Maybe the skeleton in Megumi's domain becomes fully realized, right? That's the final condition for that. Or maybe there's some secret new Shikigami. I don't really know, honestly. But it would be very interesting to see what would happen if Kashimo, or at least I should say when Kashimo destroys Mahoraga, because clearly that's what Gege is going for, and he's very, very obviously just based off of this mythology, which he's going one-to-one with. Imagine if Megumi somehow survives and he gets his body back and all of his Shikigami are destroyed. I would be very pissed. I mean, I'd be glad I got my body back, but man, first you lose your sister, second you kill all these people, and third you lose your abilities and Shikigami. Man, that's rough, I can't lie. And on top of all of his friends who are probably gonna die trying to save him too. So yeah, not looking great for Megumi EOS, even if he lives or if he dies. It's not a great future. But yeah, I hope you liked the mini theory I made on Mahoraga based on the last chapter. Hopefully we'll find out very soon if it's true. And hey, if you did enjoy the video, be sure to leave a like, it really does help out. And of course, subscribe for a ton of JJK content on the channel. If you love JJK, trust me, you will not regret it. And of course, thank you to all the channel members as well. Thank you guys very much, and that's all. Take care.